Friday, everyone, and welcome to St. Raphael Children's Ministry. Today, we're talking about recognizing God when He calls us. And to start us off, we're going to play a little game. Okay, so this game is called What'd You Say? And it's a game that you only need two people for, but you can play with as many people as are in your group.
We are joined by my lovely wife, Casey, and she has earphones on her head because the way you play this game is one person wears either headphones or earphones, or if you don't have any of that, just put your hands over your ears really tightly so you can't hear the other person. The other person, right now, that's me, I have some cards for this, but if you don't have any cards, make up some simple sentences that you want to say to the person with the headphones on, and something simple like, did you hear that? I'll say it again. Right? If you didn't hear that, that's what you want. You want to not be able to hear that, but guess what the person's saying just by what their how their mouth is moving. All right? So I'm going to try it with Casey.
You ready?
Okay. I seriously love dancing. I seriously love dancing.
I see you. What?
I seriously love dancing.
I seriously love dancing?
Yeah!
Is that what it is?
Yeah! Oh. Yeah, there you go. Okay. And we're going to see how many the person can guess in like a minute, maybe. All right. That salsa is too spicy.
Let's...
That salsa is too spicy.
Let's something your shoe basket?
That salsa.
Let's salsa?
That salsa.
The salsa.
Is too spicy.
Is goose basket. What kind of one?
That salsa is too spicy.
Oh, wow. It's like you're saying basket.
All right, that was awesome. Okay, now I'm gonna try it with the earphones and just to show you a different way of doing it. So these headphones that we have, they have some like white noise or like, it sounds like garbled conversation built in so you can't hear. So I'm gonna try with the earphones and see how that goes. And we'll see what I can guess in a minute.
Set, park closes.
Park alone.
Five.
Fassy.
Park.
A park.
Closes.
Zones.
Closes.
Lopes.
Park.
The
closes.
Park alone.
Closes.
Load.
Closes.
Load.
Closes.
Loan. Looks. Looks.
Closes. At
lose.
Five.
Losifies. Five. Lose five. What is it? Wait.
Closes.
Close.
Close.
The park.
Closes.
The park closed.
At five.
At five. The park closes at five. Yeah. Okay, let's do one more.
Okay. Can we agree?
Can we go?
Agree.
Are you hungry? Hungry. No.
Can we agree?
What?
Can we? Agree.
Agree.
That I'm right.
That I'm right? No. Okay, so if you're playing with earphones, you might have to cover your ears also, because the beginning I could kind of hear what she was saying. So I just covered my ears and then I couldn't hear. With the music playing and with my ears covered with my hands, it's totally quiet. It was awesome. So that's the game. Hope you had fun playing it. And let us know how it went on Facebook and Instagram. Now it's time for some highs and lows. We're going to share ours. And then hopefully later you can share yours with your family. You want to say what you really liked about your day?
What is something you liked about your day?
What's something I liked about my day? I liked playing the game with Mama today, and I liked, I just liked hanging out with you guys today. That was really nice. What's something you liked about your day, Mama? Very nice, Kai.
I liked hanging out with Salty this morning, and I liked that August and Salty took a nap at the same time today.
Yeah, that's right. You guys took a nap today, and while you guys were taking a nap, Mama and I played a game.
Right. And I like hanging out with you right now. What's something you liked about your day, August?
I liked that that I go to Pepper's house with the earphones. I like having the trail mix with bananas.
You had trail mix with bananas?
Yeah.
Ooh, that sounds delicious.
Really good.
There was strawberries on the picture, but Pepper didn't have strawberries.
Oh, okay.
What about something you didn't like?
But you first.
Me first, okay. Something I didn't like about today. I guess I just didn't like waking up tired. I was really tired when I woke up. Yeah, I didn't like waking up tired. What about you, Mama?
I didn't like that I didn't get to see you very much today, August. I only got to see you a little bit.
What about you?
Something you didn't like about your day, August?
You didn't get to see Mama very much.
What did you like about your day, Lucy?
What did you like? What did you not like about your day, Salty?
About the same.
Then all of them.
All right, so here we are with August. He's playing the part of my music producer right now with the earphones on. And we're talking about recognizing the voice of God, right? And responding to that voice. So we're going to sing a song called Here I Am, Lord. And it goes like this.
I, the Lord of sea and sky, I have heard my people cry, all who dwell in dark and sin, my hand will save. I who made the stars of night, I will make the darkness bright. My light to them, whom shall I send? Here I am, Lord. Is it I, Lord? I have heard you calling in the night. If you lead me, I will hold your people in my heart. I, the Lord of snow and rain, I have borne my people's pain. I have wept for love of them, they turn away. I will break their hearts of stone, give them hearts for love alone. I will speak my word to them, whom shall I send? Here I am, Lord. Is it I, Lord? I have heard you calling in the night. I will go, Lord, if you lead me. I will hold your people in my heart. I will hold your people in my heart.
In the name of that. Can you do it with your hands too? In the name of that.
Father.
Son. Holy
Spirit.
Spirit. Amen. Father God, thank you for another week, another day. Each day is a blessing. Help us make the most of this blessing today. Help this video and its message be clear so that young people and their families might recognize you in everything we do. And be with us in our children's ministry and bring us closer to you, helping us know how much you love us. In the name of your Son, Jesus, we pray. Amen. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Our scripture for this week comes from the first book of Samuel, chapter 3. And to share it with us, we have a very special guest. You all know her, Mary Bejarano.
Hi there. My name is Mary Bejarano, and this is my sister, Frances. And we're going to tell you guys a story of when God called Samuel. So Samuel was the son of Hannah, and Hannah wanted a baby boy very, very much. And when God gave her Samuel, she made sure that he was raised in the church. One day, Samuel heard a voice in the temple. At first, he thought it was a priest, Eli, but then he found out that it was God speaking to him. One night, when Samuel was sleeping, he heard someone calling his name. He got up and ran to Eli, and Samuel said,
"Here I am,"
he said to Eli. "I didn't call you," Eli answered. "Go back to bed." So Samuel went back to bed. Again, the Lord called, "Samuel." Samuel jumped out of bed and went to Eli. And Samuel said,
"Here I am."
"I didn't call you. Go back to bed," Eli answered a second time. A third time, God called Samuel, and Samuel got up and went to Eli. And Samuel said,
"Here I am."
Finally, Eli realized that it was God who was calling Samuel. He told Samuel, "Go and lie down, and if he calls you again, say, 'Speak, Lord, for your servant is listening.'" Samuel went back to bed, and sure enough, again he heard the voice of God calling, "Samuel, Samuel." This time, Samuel said,
"Speak, Lord, your servant is listening."
God spoke to Samuel and told him many things that would happen soon. God spoke to Samuel and was able to use him, even though he was young. We need to listen to God, just like Samuel did.
Thank you so much for sharing that with us, Mary. I want to share something with you all that I found to be true in my life. God is always calling us. He's always calling me. He's always calling you. Sometimes we hear him, but we don't understand what he's saying to us. Sometimes we hear him and understand him, but like Samuel, we don't know that it's him. So we don't really know how to respond in the right way. Samuel had Eli to help him know that the person who was calling him was God. Do you have someone like that in your life? Someone that knows the voice of God and can help you recognize it and know how to respond? I want to invite you to do something with me this week. You can do it on your own or as a family. Set a timer for 5 minutes every day this week and spend just 5 minutes without anything around you, no music, no videos, no people talking. Just 5 minutes of quiet and say to God, "Here I am, Lord. Your servant is listening." And see if you hear him say anything back to you in those 5 minutes. You might be surprised with what happens. It's now time to walk over to our altar and offer up the intentions for the week. Now, this week our altar is on our ofrenda for Dia de los Muertos. And looking at all these pictures reminds me again that we are never alone, that we have so many saints who love us, guiding us from heaven, praying on our behalf, and just being there with us, giving us strength, supporting us. Here are the petitions that were sent in and ones that I've added this week for you all, for my family, and for this ministry. Let's lift them up to God as we close today's session in prayer. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen. Father God, help us know what you sound like, so that we can always recognize your voice and be ready when you call. Surround us with people who care about us and can help us get to know you better. Please accept these prayers and intentions that we lift up to you and fill us with your peace and your grace, knowing that you hear our prayers. Keep us all safe this week and take care of those who are suffering in our families and our community. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen.
In the name of the Father, and in the Son, and in the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Thanks so much for joining us this Friday. If you liked what you saw, hit the like button and tell your friends about it. And let us know on Facebook or Instagram if there's a topic or a Bible story that you'd like us to go over on this channel. Have a wonderful weekend. God bless you.